गुड मॉर्निंग ब्रदर्स एंड सिस्टर्स, लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, स्पोर्ट्समैन, स्टूडेंट्स, स्कॉलर्स, टीचर्स, ट्रेनर्स, प्रोफेसर्स, प्रोफेशनल्स, लर्नर्स एंड लिसनर्स, एडवोकेट्स, एडवर्टाइजर्स, administrators and advisors, those who belong to the field of science, religion, spirituality, arts, commerce and engineering, the most respectable present Prime Minister, Sen Dr. Narendra Modi ji, presence of ministers and doctors, reverend fathers and mothers, and affectionate sons and daughters. I, Dr. Akesh from USA, heartily, cordially welcome all of you. It is very nice time, nice place, and nice action of listening. With 100% presence, sense of mind, it is the greatest and highest bless, grace of God that we are listening and watching about the appreciation, praise, admiration of the Almighty Lord. He who will, and he who was, in present, past and future, he who is omnipotent, omnipresent, omniscient. We always remember him in the form of audios and videos. In this modern time, the place of Lord or God has taken by social media, social sites, our software and hardware system in advanced technology that we use, and we have become the believer, follower and devotee of these electronic devices that are made by mind. Who made the mind? Who is the maker of mind? We have forgot him. If the speed, accuracy, and time, place that we use for the technology is so powerful, influential of our lifestyle, then how is the lifestyle of the spiritual world? Oh man, try to understand it. What's your duty to come on this land? What's your duty by having the human birth on this land? A power, a spiritual power, who can bring, who can create, generate, operate something न्यू रीन्यू इज द मोस्ट पावरफुल वी शुड नॉट फॉरगेट हिम अनोइंगली अनडाउटेडली इफ वी बिलीव इन आवर टैलेंट मैनर स्किल एंड गॉड गिफ्टेड presentations, then we are ignorant. Almighty, who can provide us, and within 1 second, by allowing the natural calamities, disasters, devastations, he can snatch He can take back everything whatsoever he has provided us. So the nature of Lord, nature of God, whose color, change, style, standard, manner we observe, examine and evaluate everywhere in the world. On the earth, in the ocean, in the sky, he who is the most powerful, the most fluent, and his speed and his ways, means are really heart-throbbing, man cannot understand the ununderstandable. Man cannot change the unchangeable. If we are the true believer, ardent and staunch believer, of the doctrine or principle of our life, then we must recall, remember, return the teachings and education, lessons and learnings of our forefathers, those who are the starters, beginners, initiators, our forefathers, foretellers, forecasters. They are the foundation. They provide us fundamentals of our lifestyle. How we should spend our life. They instruct us, direct us, inform us to be devoted, dedicated towards the moral, spiritual, social, economical, educational values of our education, of our society, the laws that we study in the nature, in commerce, arts, engineering, science. These laws, rules and regulations have come from the law of nature. Nature, which was the cooperator, supporter, friend of our beginners, holy scripture writers, those who came first on this land, We cannot repay anything to them. They are only kept in our museums. They are being counted as our national and social heritage. And we remember them just as a property of our nation and society. But the values that are practically and fundamentally to be applied in our behavior, in our speaking, reading, writing, listening, in all the actions of expositions, impressions, if we fundamentally adopt them, practically use them, then there is no frustration, no depression, no anxiety, because we are fully aware, awakened about our spiritual or soul power. Our spirit or soul that we feel, imagine, sometimes imitate in the form of virtues, qualities, skills, talents, manners and styles. But the natural style of nature is the utmost, and that is unimagined, that is unimitated, that is uncopier. If our 1% is powerful, our mind, which is 1% only of the God's power, His energy, but how is the power of that Lord who always sharing, subscribing, liking, loving the generation with His 99% energy. His energy, His followers, His volunteers, those who are working, how is their potential? How is their energy is being worked for fulfilling the aim and objectives of every organ of the universe? That is unread, unspoken, unheard, uncounted, O man, we should remember the starters, Swami Vivekananda, who started Ramkishan Mission. In 1893, Swami Vivekananda went in the USA, in the America, for addressing the whole universe by His words. My brothers and sisters of the America, What a purity of the words, purity of thoughts. Swamiji expressed, Gautam Buddha, who was the starter of Buddhism, Mahavir Swami, who was the starter of Jainism, starter of Brahm Samaj, Raja Ram Mohan Roy, starter of Arya Samaj, Dayanand Saraswati. So the whole history, recordings, downloadings, savings of our present, past and future is immortal and unperishable. Our Indian land is known as multiculturalist, multilinguist. Throughout the world, our forefathers, astronomers, astrologers, scientists and scholars, sportsmen and students, researchers went in the different universities for their higher studies. Their aim and objective was not only to create or recreate the social and cultural values of India, but also for providing the spiritual knowledge in the higher universities of education, in the field of health, education, security, commerce, arts and engineering throughout the world. Be proud on them, on its heritage, our cultural background, the history, our past that was recalled by Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, who wrote Discovery of India. In this writing, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru explained, our present lies in the past, and if we want to observe the glimpse of India, that is possible only through the Vedas, the Ramayana, the Mahabharata. Our Indian land is known as the land of greatest personalities, Mahatma Gandhi, who started the truth and non-violence. Throughout the world, after completing his barrister from South Africa, he came back in India and fought for the nation and society with the greatest principle or doctrine, the truth and non-violence, which is the base of our religious values, that was spread out by that freedom fighter, our Indian land is the land of freedom fighters, free thinkers, messengers, those who came on this land for others, not for their selfishness. And it was the lesson that Swami Vivekananda addressed. O man, your first duty to do the work selflessly by being selfless. If you will contribute your actions with your true actions, then you will know the true values of our motherland. Then you will become the true nationalistic and patriotic person of our nation and society. About the concept of success, Swami Vivekananda addressed, success means not the platform. Success means not the destination. But success means continuity and regularity. Success means to be unrelenting, unceasing and unstopping at the same place, same path, that you are repeating. Don't keep in your mind about the fruits, bottom to top, root to fruit, your aim, your target is to do something different. This was the principle, lifestyle of our simple and modest personalities of this land. Saint messengers, those who came, they made us aware about the unity, oneness, and this one idea, one thought, one man army that is inside the body, inside the nature of man, that exists in the spiritual education. If every Indian or citizen of our nation will follow the path of cleanliness, strong determination for fighting against the diseases, natural calamities, natural disasters, devastations that are the most powerful. One positive idea, one positive psychology can change the direction. Its direction, instruction, information, everything that today we are using for defending our nation. But if we are the true defender, then we are to avoid the habit of attacking on others. It is man's first duty. It is the true education by being a doctor, engineer, minister. We have forgot the humanitarian works, social works that are greatly needed for the upliftment and betterment of our society, nation. That's why our present Prime Minister, Sen Dr. Narendra Modi ji, time and again made us aware by being the follower of Sayam and Sankalp, से हम इस युद्ध को जीत सकते हैं. यूनिटी एंड डाइवर्सिटी ही एड्रेस्ड थ्रू आउट द वर्ल्ड. डिजिटल इंडिया ही एस्टैब्लिश्ड एज ए फाउंडेशन ऑफ द न्यू वर्ल्ड ऑफ नेशन. बाय ट्रांसपेरेंसी ही प्रोवाइडेड the latest inventive and innovative advancement in technology. Swami Keshwananda ji, who started the greatest mission of providing education in the state of Rajasthan, Swami Vivekananda, who born in West Bengal but went throughout the world for addressing the message of humanity, appealed, advocated the cultural values of our society. Sai Shyam Stanaji Maharaj, who started the true bargain in 1948. Our India got freedom in 1947. He came in India in 1948 for the freedom of our soul. By the glimpse of our history, if we recalled the starter of Sri Guru Granth Sahib, the starter of Sikhism, Sri Guru Nanak Dev Ji Maharaj, who came on this land in 1469, Vasco da Gama, who discovered India in 1498, William Shakespeare, who born in 1564, and Saint Kabir, who came on this land as an interactor, mediator of all the cultures of our nation. So our land is known as by the sacrificial bodies, those who devoted themselves for the welfare, goodnesses, we are to take the lesson from such personalities, those who were very near with nature. Nature provided them their shelter, food and clothing for spending friendly relations, for the spiritual power. for the soul power. Every scholar, every learner today is trying best. But how it can be achieved, obtained? How it can be obtained and achieved, it does matter. We believe in the feelings, emotionality, intellectuality, but the subject of spirituality is above. Upon it, the highest level it has. How a man can reach at the unimaginative place? This is the great training which can be achieved only with the nature. If someone has become the victim of any drawback, shortcoming, faults, he must remember that this one weakness can become his achievement. So never feel back, never have inferiorities, but think greater, finer, nicer for our nation. God Himself says He does exist in the five elements, in air, fire, soil, sky and water. Even God claims that He does exist where there is no fire, where there is no light, where there is no sky. Means airless, fireless, soilless, skyless, waterless place is also the existence of Lord. Even Swami Vivekananda proved in the whole history that our God also does exist in lightless and soundless places. This is the greatest message which should be adopted by our present generation. Our youth can turn the picture of our whole society. We are to save ourselves. We are to be ready to face the challenges that can be harmful for our soul or spirit. There is no enemy in this world, but for damaging, spoiling the talent of our true spirit or soul in the form of negativities, evils that are always disturbing us.